Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Lucy's Science Library. It's another Strange Stuff Sundays where we talk about books and topics that don't fit into the normal book review. And today we got another interesting one about speculative zoology. It's After Man by Dougal Dixon. As always, please stick around to the end of the video for the cute bunny clip. You know it's one of the two major things we're all here for, so come on, watch it all the way through. Also, please check out Ben G. Thomas's Speculative Zoology series. It's where I found this book, as well as All Tomorrows, which we discussed in a previous video. Also check that out. And one last thing before we get into the book review. I'm trying out being an Amazon associate, so if you have any interest in this book or anything else by Dougal Dixon, please use my Amazon link below. It really helps the channel grow, and we'll see how it goes. With that out of the way, After Man by Dougal Dixon. Who is Dougal Dixon, and what's this book about? Dougal Dixon is a Scottish-born geologist and paleontologist, fitting right into the niche of scientists, science fiction writers that we've been discussing in previous videos. He has a long list of publications, both nonfiction and fiction, which is way too extensive for me to get into here, so definitely check out his website, which I'll link here and below. After Man is perhaps one of his most famous books. It deals with the subject of what life on Earth would evolve into if humankind were to go extinct. Like All Tomorrows, After Man is written in the style of a textbook that somebody brought back from the future. However, unlike All Tomorrows, After Man is much more grounded in hard science and explains its world in that way. Dixon really takes his time in the first 10 to 15 pages to explain all the sciences that make his predictions possible. He goes into basic geology, evolutionary science, biology, even as far back as the origin of life, to really set up the groundwork for the world that he's laying down in this book. You can definitely tell where his background experience is extensive, and he explains it pretty well before getting into the main bulk of the story. After all that, though, we're into the weird part of the book, the uncharted part, so to speak. The rest of this book deals with Earth's many biomes and the types of life forms that would evolve after humankind went extinct. In Dixon's scenario, humankind went extinct because of logistics issues and resource mismanagement.
Because that's not real at all.
And this book picks up 50 million years after humankind has been wiped off the face of the Earth, as well as any traces of them. However, their impact is still felt with what species make it this far. The book is divided by each biome and the higher life forms that inhabit them. All evolved from species that were around when we were today, like rabbits, bats, birds, etc. And while all of these simpler mammals and birds and other life forms have evolved into strange, bizarre, crazy shapes, Dixon does a great job of explaining his logic as to why they look the way they do and why they evolved the way they did. So it's all very natural and believable that this world could and probably might happen if we actually go extinct like he suggests. Okay, into the pros and cons of this book. Now, most of the books I talk about on these Sundays I really like, so there's going to be a lot more pros for this than cons. However, there are a couple minor gripes, so we'll cover those first. The one real main kind of gripe that I can see people having with After Man is that it's dense. Now, when you just look at it, it looks pretty thin, and you've probably seen some of the pictures flying across the screen to this point of the illustrations of Dixon's monsters. So you might think this is something that you could pick up and tear through in an afternoon, but there is a lot of legitimate, textbook-written kind of science in here that really fleshes out and explains these creatures. So when you're reading this book, you're essentially reading a biology textbook of things that could happen. So in that way, it's not going to be as easy to tear through as like a sci-fi short story or a novel of some sort. Now, the only other con I can see people having is in fact the complete opposite of that prior one we were talking about. Some people might not like that this is written like a textbook for high schoolers and college students and that it has pictures. There's some readers that are more into sci-fi for the hard concepts like astrophysics or really dense books that deal with really hard concepts. And they might view something like this as a little bit more childish, but I would personally disagree with that sentiment. And in fact, the first con is a pro for me. Like, I like how in-depth and in-detail Dixon really goes with this book. But I do bring up both because I know some readers might not like that. And since we bled into it a little bit with those two cons, let's talk about the many pros of this book. There is so much here to offer. I mean, you'll get a crash course in geology and biology and all those topics before you even begin. So there's merit there alone. But then the imagination that Dixon provides to get his creatures to life is just simply extraordinary. Almost all of the evolved creatures that Dixon imagines in this book are very believable from their humble origins 50 million years before the start of it. They all fit the niches in their biomes really well too, and you can see a lot of care went into how he explains these environments and how these creatures fit in and interact with them. Also, as we showed before, the illustrations in this book are just top-notch. Like, look at some of these. These are incredible. They really enhance that textbook from the future kind of feel and that encyclopedia biology kind of vibe that it's going with really well. And I think the book would be a lot lesser without them, which is why I disagreed with the previous con we talked about. And a bit like what we talked about with All Tomorrows, After Man's just really imaginative. It's nice to really get a look into Dixon's mind and to see a world completely different from our own, but also somewhat similar. Now, it doesn't go as wild and off the rails as All Tomorrows does, but I really like the idea of an Earth after humankind and what would happen to it and all the possibilities that exist within that idea. So overall, this is going to be another Strange Stuff Sundays where I get a hard recommend for it. You should definitely read this book.
You should also definitely click the Amazon link. That'd be really cool.
But you should just give it a chance. I mean, if nothing else, go to Dougal Dixon's website, which we mentioned before, because it's some really interesting stuff. And if you want to read about this topic from the experience and viewpoint of an expert, there's no better person to go to. As always, thank you for watching all the way to the end of the video. You know what's coming next. Cute bunny clip. Follow the social media, also linked down below. And thanks again for watching. Hi.